Joe Muhammad Nafia. Today we are going to be reading one of my favorite classical stories, based on the story by Brothers Grimm, illustrated by Mike Roden, retold by Susanna Davidson. So shall we begin? Once upon a time, there was a little tiny girl called Little Red Riding. She always wore a bright red cloak with a bright red horn. I love it so much, I will never take it off. Little Red Riding Hood and her mother lived in the edge of some deep, dark woods. One day, Little Red Riding Hood's mother gave her a pot of vegetable soup. "Take this to your grandmother," she said. "She's not feeling well." "But remember the rules of the woods," her mother added. "Keep to the path, don't talk to wolves." My lunch. At first, the sun shone and the birds sang. Little Red Riding Hood hummed a tune. Bent down to tie her shoelace. Skipped along the path, stopped to smell some flowers. At last. "Good morning," Little Red Riding Hood called to a woodcutter. "Good morning." "Good morning," said the woodcutter, waving to him. "I know how to run ahead of her. Wait." Little Red Riding Hood walked deeper and deeper into the woods. The sun hid behind the clouds, got darker still. So Little Red Riding Hood couldn't see the wolf waiting for her in the path. The wolf didn't see Little Red Riding Hood either. Little Red Riding Hood stepped on the wolf's tail, then on his paw, "My paw," and then dropped her basket smack on the wolf's head. "Where you're going," said the wolf huffily. "But you were in the middle of the path," said Little Red Riding Hood. "She'd forgotten the rule. Don't talk to wolves." "What have you got in that basket?" said the wolf hungrily.
"Vegetable soup,"
replied Red Riding Hood. "I'm taking it to my grandmother."
"Vegetables? How the fault?"
"Wolves all made juicy red meat. I never touch vegetables," he added. "Now time for my lunch," he thought. The wolf was about to gobble up Little Red Riding Hood, but then he had an idea. "Perhaps I can eat Little Red Riding Hood and her grandmother," he thought. Put on softest voice.
"Where does your grandmother live?"
"In that cottage on the other side of the woods," said the Red Riding Hood.
"How perfect," thought the wolf. "How delicious.
Why don't you take some flowers?" "What a kind wolf you are," said Little Red Riding Hood. So Little Red Riding Hood left the path to look for some flowers. The wolf raced off to Grandmother's house. He knocked on the door lightly. Tap, tap, tap. "I'm wonderful," clever.
"Who's there?" asked Grandmother. and gobbled up Rudolph's Riding Hood's grandmother. Then he climbed onto the bed. To wait for Little Red Riding Hood. Soon he heard a knock at the door.
"Who's there?"
he said.
"Your granddaughter, Little Red Riding Hood. Let yourself in," called the wolf. "I'm too weak to get up."
He pulled the grandmother's cap and hid under the blankets.
"I've bought you some lovely vegetable soup," said Little Red Riding Hood.
"Lovely," snarled the wolf.
"I mean lovely,"
he snarled. Riding Hood looked at her grandmother and looked again.
"Oh, grandmother, what big ears you have."
"All the better to hear you with," said the wolf. The Red Riding Hood came closer to the bed. "Oh, grandmother, what big eyes you have. All the better to see you." Came closer to the bed.
"Oh, grandmother, what big hairy hands you have. All the better to hug you with."
Little Red Riding Hood was now standing right next to the bed.
"But, grandmother, what big sharp teeth you have."
"All the better to eat you," snapped the wolf. Jumped out of bed and gobbled Little Red Riding Hood up.
"Delicious,"
he thought.
"Full at last,"
he said, licking his lips. Then he lay in the bed to sleep. The wolf slept and snored very loudly.
So loudly that the woodcutter heard.
"I've never heard that old woman snore that loudly. Make sure she's okay." But the woodcutter couldn't see the grandmother anywhere. Only a very fat wolf.
"Oh no,"
thought the woodcutter. "The wolf's eaten the old woman." Just then he had an idea.
"Perhaps
the old woman is still inside you. I might be able to save her." Picked up some scissors and cut open the wolf's tummy.
"Phew, keep cutting,"
she cried.
"Grandma's still in there."
Snippity snip, faster and faster, wolf cut and kept cutting until grandmother popped out too.
"Did I fall asleep?"
Quick as a flash, Little Red Riding Hood ran outside and picked up lots of stones. The woodcutter put them inside the wolf's tummy. Grandma sewed up. When the wolf woke up, he tried to sneak out the door, but the stone rattles inside.
"Now everyone can hear you coming," said the woodcutter, laughing. "But I'll never catch anyone,"
cried the wolf.
"Exactly," said the woodcutter.